I want to talk to you today about the basics of wood screws. A lot of times I see homeowners who are using the wrong screw for a particular application, so I thought maybe just going over some of the basics would be useful for some people. The original wood screw looked something like this, and this particular one is made of brass. Sometimes they're made of steel. But what's interesting to note is that the shank of the screw gets bigger or thicker, wider, as you get closer to the head. So when you're using this basic wood screw, and this is, you know, probably the original one, you need to drill a pilot hole so that as you're screwing together whatever you're screwing together, this area right here has a place to go. And that pilot hole with a special bit provides that space. As time went by, that's not the right one. I want this one. As time went by, that basic wood screw has been modified so that the shank is now the same size all the way up and down. So, let me see if I can compare this. I'm getting trouble getting my fingers in here. So if you compare this, you know, this is a different size screw, obviously, but this screw here has the wider shank on the top. This one does not. So when you're picking a basic wood screw like this, look for those differences. If it is like this, then you need to drill a pilot hole to account for that shank. If it's like this, it's more like a deck screw, which I'll get to in a second, and you may not need to drill a pilot hole. And these screws can be made of different materials, as I said. So you have brass here. This one's a steel. This is an older one, but it's also steel. And the heads, there's some things to consider. One is that the type of driver used can vary. So this is a Phillips head, of course. And if I go back to this one, this is a flat screwdriver head. And then the head of the screw can be a flat style like this. It can be a round style like this. And typically the round style, you know, the screw is meant to sit on the surface of the wood, whereas the flat style, again, you'll have a pilot hole drilled, and that pilot hole will allow for this to be sort of buried in the wood. It's so this flat part here will sit flush with the surface. So depending on your application, you may choose to use a flat or a round head. And whether you use brass or steel, or even stainless steel and even aluminum sometimes, also depends on what you're doing. You know, brass is not going to rust. So if you're in an environment where there's a lot of moisture and that kind of thing, or salt water, then brass is going to be your choice. If that's not an issue, steel might be a better choice because it's stronger. So brass is a soft metal, but it doesn't rust, but the steel is stronger. I'll just get into, let me find the right ones here, deck screws. Deck screws have a shank. It has a fairly aggressive thread, okay, meaning it's a coarse thread. And it typically, or the original ones anyway, had a bugle head right here, it's called. So it's flat on top, and this area right here looks like a bugle. And the shank is all the same thickness all the way up and down. So oftentimes you can get away with not drilling a pilot hole with this, because the shank isn't widening and it won't split the wood apart. A drywall screw, if I put this side by side, is very similar. In fact, they look almost identical. And even though the threads are almost the same, what's not the same is the metal itself. Drywall screws are very brittle, and they have a specific purpose, which is to hold the drywall to studs. A deck screw is not as brittle in the metal, and this particular one here has a coating on it which is designed for exterior use, so it won't rust. So there are, they look similar, but there are big differences between the two. You should never use a drywall screw on a deck, and I do see that done from time to time. Another, let me just find the right one here. This is another type of drywall screw, and this one has a very fine thread here. And they're sold that way. So this drywall screw is a coarse thread. This one's a fine thread. The difference is this fine thread is typically used in a situation where you have steel studs. So it's really not the best for wood. The thread is not aggressive enough, and it won't grab, or it'll pull out if you give it too much twist. This one with a coarser thread is better idea for wood. And let me see if I can. This one, this one here is another type of screw. It's very similar to a deck screw. This one has a square drive to it, and it also has a bugle head. But this one is stainless steel. And stainless steel is a very soft metal, but it won't rust. So again, if you're in a marine environment, for example, or somewhere where it's wet all the time, this is a good choice. And this particular style has something, I don't know if I can see it, if you can see it here, but you see on this pointy area where you just start to enter the wood, it has kind of a cutout right here. That cutout helps to kind of chew away the wood as you're driving this into a piece of wood. And so it makes it easier to drive, and it helps kind of drill out a hole for the threads. When you're drilling a pilot hole, in this case, this screw is designed not to need one, but when you are drilling a pilot hole, you want to make sure that the drill bit is about the same as the shank minus the threads. So these threads should kind of hold on their own. You don't want to drill too big a hole or these threads won't have anything to grab. So when you're drilling a pilot hole, you know, you want the drill to kind of overlap the shank part, but not the threads. Here is another type of deck screw, which looks kind of strange. Now you'll notice a few things here. First of all, you have that cutout down here, which helps it kind of drill its own pilot hole. It has the threads that you're used to seeing on a deck screw here, but up on the top part of the shank, it has these very fine threads, and the head is a square drive, and it's kind of a bugle head, but it's kind of an abrupt ending here. This particular screw is designed for use on decks when you have like Trex or other composite forms of decking. And the idea is that this area of the thread right here will screw into the deck joist, and this area right here, it's actually a reverse thread. And what it does is the composite decking material tends to chew out and kind of have little pieces of plastic essentially come out of the hole as you're drilling it in, and it makes for an ugly installation. So these threads here kind of capture that plastic of the decking itself and kind of shoves it back into the hole. So when you drive this in, this part here will hold into the wood, and this part here will kind of capture that plastic and drive it back into the hole, so that in the end you have a nice neat installation and you don't have a little bump sticking out where the head of the screw goes. What else do we have here? We have, get some of these out of the way, trim screws. There's one, I have another one here, there it is. Trim screws look similar to drywall or decking screws, and this particular one here has a drywall screw kind of metal, so it is brittle. This one here is stainless steel. Both have a square head, but the point of these is that it has a very tiny head. And let me just compare it to a regular drywall screw so you can see the difference there. So these trim screws here on the bottom, with that tiny head, you can connect two pieces of wood, say, and that tiny head doesn't show as much as a giant one like this would. So it's used in installations where you want to hide the screw as best you can. Those are some of the basic ones. Now let me get into some more unusual ones. These screws here, this particular one is used for connecting metal connectors that are used in framing, and it's got this special flat head on it, sometimes called a pan head, sometimes called a truss head, and it's also a very strong screw. It's a Phillips drive, but that head is quite large and quite flat, so it's designed to hold, it's almost like a washer. It's kind of like having a built-in washer. This screw right here is another example of the same idea, where it has that pan head or washer head or truss head. And this also has, this one's designed more for metal. It has this little area right here is designed to be able to kind of drill, self-tap or drill through the metal. So this is really not meant for wood applications, but I do see it used sometimes. Let's give you some more specialty screws. This one here is designed for Craig jigs, which is a special kind of connector. And again, it has a rounded head, a square drive to it, and it also has, look, it also has that cutout, if I can get to it, right here, so that it kind of self-drills. this screw right here is one example of many that uses a special head right here. I don't know if you can see it on camera, but they're kind of little ears that stick out there. And then this thread has, it's almost like a serrated edge. Well, it is a serrated edge. And this is designed for use when you're attaching cement backer board to wood. So this part right here aggressively drills into the wood. And this little head here with these tiny little ears kind of cams out in the backer board and kind of scrapes away a place for this bugle head to be. So that's a specialty screw, and it's only designed for that purpose. Here's another specialty screw that this is designed to look kind of old-fashioned. It's kind of a standard straight shank thread here, but if you look at the head, if I can get in here, the head is designed to kind of look like an old-fashioned nail or something like that. So this is just scratching the surface of the screws available to you, but the things you want to look for when you're picking a screw are, number one, the type of driver. So Phillips is designed so that when you get the screw kind of tight, it cams out. In other words, the screwdriver kind of comes out on its own. And so that it has four sides here, which makes it easier to get started. But once you get tight, then the screwdriver wants to cam out. So that is that type. A flat screwdriver has a longer stretch here for the screwdriver to bite into, so it is more difficult to get started, but once you get to the end, you can often give it more drive or more torque to get this screw in if you need it. The type of shank is the next thing you want to look for. So if it's a standard wood screw like this, keep in mind you need to do a pilot hole. If it's more like a deck screw or a drywall screw, you may not need to do a pilot hole. The type of material, remember, you have stainless steel like this, you have brass, which is good for wet environments, marine environments. Both of these metals are softer, so if you really crank down on this, you have a tendency to break the screw right off, but they won't rust. If strength is more important, then a steel screw like this one or like this one is going to be a better bet, because you can really crank down on it and it won't snap, but it is going to rust if you're in a wet environment. And some of the specialty screws, just to remember, you have, you know, some of these areas here to cut out to kind of self-drill. You have specialty heads like this one and this one. So whatever you're doing, just pay attention to some of these things that we're talking about here so that you pick the right screw. You shouldn't be using a drywall screw to hang cabinets, for example. They make a special screw for that. You shouldn't be using, you know, drywall screws to screw down decking, or expensive decking screws to screw down drywall, you know. So there are different purposes for these screws. And as you're getting started, it can be confusing, but these are some of the things you want to look for. And typically the boxes that you buy these on will explain to some degree what the screw is used for, especially if it's some kind of specialty. But that's getting started with the basics of wood screws.